do need to advise you that this is on today for purposes of an arraignment based upon three felony complaints that have been filed against you. Those include criminal possession of a controlled substance in the third degree in violation of section 220.16 subdivision 1 of the penal law, criminal possession of a controlled substance in the third degree in violation of section 220.16 subdivision 12 of the penal law, and criminal possession of a firearm in violation of section 265.01 of the penal law. I do need to advise you, Mr. Granison, that you do have the right to an attorney, and you have the right to have an attorney assigned to represent you at no cost if you cannot afford one. I believe that you've retained Mr. DeMarco to represent you. Is that correct, Mr. Granison?
Your Honor, I will be appearing on behalf of Mr. Granison, and I would waive a further reading of the complaints and ask that you enter a not guilty plea on each and every charge before the court.
All right, so noted. And with respect to release on his own recognizance or bail, Mr. Clark.
Your Honor, my understanding is that under the bail reform laws, these are not bail eligible offenses.
Accordingly, Your Honor, I would request Mr. Granison's release. I also have some comments I'd like to make with respect to the sufficiency of the accusatory instruments.
All right, go ahead, Mr. DeMarco.
Your Honor, I was provided this morning three single page felony complaints. I also have a history through NYSID as well, which reflects that Mr. Granison has no convictions. With respect to the accusatories, are all brought on behalf of Anthony J. Gower, who is, it's reflected, is stationed at State Police Headquarters, I believe Troop E, in Canandaigua. I'm not sure whether Mr. Gower is an investigator or holds some other position. With respect to the possession charges, again, there are no supporting depositions connected with these accusatories. There are no lab reports connected with accusatories. There are no field tests connected with the accusatories. There is no information which provides any background about Trooper Gower and what training, experience, education that he may hold to form the conclusion or opinion that the materials that were located do constitute what they allege to be cocaine. Similarly, with respect to the Class E felony firearm charge, they're also lack supporting information that would tend to support the elements of that charge as well. So with respect to the two accusatories, or the three accusatories at this point, I would ask that the court summarily dismiss them based upon their facial insufficiency.
Thank you, Mr. DeMarco. Mr. Clark.
Your Honor, the people oppose defense counsel's request. First, I would ask that any motions to dismiss be made in writing pursuant to the CPL. Additionally, I note that case law simply requires that accusatory instruments, complaints, give defendant notice of what they're being charged with. The people submit that these complaints are facially sufficient and that they do exactly that. And if the court were to entertain defense counsel's motion right now, I ask that you deny it. Thank you.
Very good. Thank you. Mr. DeMarco, at this point, I am going to deny your application without prejudice. Specifically, I would request that any motion based upon the sufficiency be made in writing. And Mr. Granison, I do need to talk to you a little bit about your release on your own recognizance. I need to advise you some things, and I need to advise you, first of all, that you're being released on your own recognizance in order to appear at your next court date and any other court dates thereafter. You are legally obligated to appear at every court date which is scheduled for your case at the time the court appearance is scheduled, and remain in court until your case is concluded. If you fail to appear for a scheduled court date, you may have a bench warrant issued directing a police officer to take you into custody and bring you to court. You may also have additional conditions imposed upon you, including non-monetary conditions like supervision by a pretrial services agency or electronic monitoring, the requirement to post monetary bail, etc. Do you understand that, Mr. Granison?
Yes, ma'am.
And this is no way a reflection that you'll fail to appear. These are just warnings that I'm required to provide to you, okay? The court will also remind you of upcoming court appearances, but if you do not get that notification, that is not an excuse not to appear. Do you understand that?
Yes, ma'am.
And you have the right to be present at every date on which your case is scheduled. If you voluntarily fail to appear in court on time for a scheduled court date, the court may conduct proceedings in the case without you, including a pretrial hearing or any other hearings or appearances in this matter. If that occurs, you would lose your important right to participate in these proceedings and waive or forfeit your right to be present on such dates. And do you understand that?
Understood.
All right. So let's talk about how would you like to proceed today, Mr. Clark and Mr. DeMarco, as far as the next court appearance.
Your Honor, a couple items. Number one, I did not want to interrupt you. I would ask the court to note my exception to the court's ruling with respect to denial of the dismissal of the accusatories.
So noted.
Thank you. Your Honor, with respect to an adjourned date, a couple matters. Number one, I've had a chance to briefly speak with Mr. Clark. I don't want to put words in his mouth, but I think the Monroe County District Attorney's Office is still reviewing the matter somewhat in totality. I don't know whether or not they have determined at what pace, if they decide to move forward with an indictment, they would do that, and whether or not that would be limited to solely Mr. Granison or perhaps even others. So I think it behooves not only the court respectfully, but my representation of Mr. Granison, that we put as much time as the court would allow between today and giving the district attorney's office an opportunity to decide how they want to proceed. I guess that's a long way of saying I'm looking for something more than a week or two.
I also
have a conflict myself with respect to a pending trial date in federal court outside the state of New York. Such that I would appreciate a 30-day adjournment to appear back before you or another judge that might be assigned for control purposes. And lastly, I would like the record to reflect that in the event that the matter was to proceed to the grand jury between now and the next control date, defendant does wish to testify before that body as of today's date.
Very good. Thank you, Mr. DeMarco. Mr. Clark, do you have any objection to keeping this matter local for a period of time? And I believe Mr. DeMarco was requesting about a 30-day adjournment.
Your Honor, I have no objection to defense counsel's request. What I indicated to him is that I'm not making any promises as far as whether or not the case will be presented to a grand jury between now and the next court date. I am serving a grand jury notice upon defense counsel now. The record, please reflect that.
And I do acknowledge receipt, Your Honor.
Very good.
And that's all I have. Thank you.
All right. I'm just going to mute for 1 minute to get a date on which this matter will be placed back on my calendar.
Additionally, I do note defendant's request to testify in grand jury. I would ask counsel to follow up in writing in that respect, but I will note the file.
All right, how about if we have this back on the calendar, June 21st at 10 a.m.
And Your Honor, for the time being, unless we hear otherwise, that you'll keep this on your own calendar.
That's right. I was just going to say, with the caveat that I was assigned this case for purposes of arraignment, I'm not certain if I'll continue to be the judge handling this case locally, but for now, I'll put it on my calendar for June 21st at 10 a.m., and unless you hear otherwise, it'll be heard on that date.
Your Honor, is that virtual, in person?
That would be virtual.
Okay.
Is there any objection to this matter proceeding virtually for now?
No, I have no objection, Your Honor, to proceeding virtually now or in the future.
Mr. DeMarco, any objection to the next court date being virtual?
I have none, Your Honor, and when we... When we talk about virtual in this context, that would obviously not require Mr. Granison or myself to be present inside the Hall of Justice.
That's correct. That would be everybody appearing virtually on camera.
No opposition, Your Honor.
Your Honor, additionally, okay. I don't recall if we covered this during the first portion of the matter before we had the technical problems, but Mr. DeMarco, do you also have no objection to proceeding virtually today with the arraignment?
I do not, Your Honor.
Okay, very good.